So every time I seem to make a video about this topic, I seem to get a lot of good feedback and a lot of DMs and comments about people struggling with the same thing. You know, I always was worried about exploiting my addiction for clicks and views, which is why I didn't ever really make too many videos on it. I think this is the third video in total in the year and a half that I've been doing YouTube that I've made on this topic. And each time I make one, I get a lot, like I was gonna say, I get a lot of comments and DMs about people struggling with this also. So I think by me talking about this, maybe I just didn't really comprehend how much it actually does help people. As it is so obvious to me, my addiction and my struggles that I went through, I forget that it's not so obvious to somebody who's trying to get help and abstain from whatever it may be, whether it's drugs, alcohol, sex, gambling, overeating, anything. I've also gotten a lot of comments about my addiction and maybe some details on it. I never really go into detail on it because I don't necessarily think that it is important. And also, there's one key thing that I really struggled with when I was in my early sobriety and my early stages of recovery that I would always get very insecure about. And that was the fact that I didn't end up in an alleyway with a needle in my arm. I was never actually fully physically dependent on anything. And that's what a lot of people who don't know a lot about addiction think addiction is. And addiction is so much more than that, and it runs so much deeper. It's literally something within you, and it's like who you are almost at the core of your person. And I've been fortunate enough to go through experiences that helped me realize that, and I can use that not only to my advantage, but to help other people. And now I have this platform. Yeah, I was a binge drinker. That was my major thing. Obviously, I've dabbled with, you know, every sort of drug. My downfall was binge drinking, and there's a lot of people who struggle with binge drinking that do need help and that do eventually obtain some form of sobriety. Oh, I'm saying some form of sobriety. They obtain sobriety. And I thought since I was so young, you know, that it was normal what I was doing. I was 18, 19 years old doing drugs and drinking like what I thought every other 19 and 18 year old does. And, you know, come years later down the line, you know, it's gonna be 8 years in July, and it's the more time I stay sober, the more and more I realize that that doesn't matter. The longer I actually stay sober, the more I realize how much I don't have anything really figured out. And what I mean by that is the second you think you have like this whole addiction thing like figured out, it like comes out from under you, and it comes at you sideways in a way where you didn't expect it. Like, my addictive personality and my addiction manifests in so many different ways in my life, whether it's getting obsessed over like work or skateboarding or women or anything at all, really. That can ruin my life just as much as drinking and drugs can, if I allow it to. You know, whatever makes my life unmanageable, that's like where I notice my addiction manifesting. I don't really know where I'm going with that. I think I'm just trying to like tell you guys, I'm just trying to be more detailed and descriptive and transparent about the addiction, because you don't have to be in an alleyway with a needle sticking out of your arm. You don't have to be physically dependent on anything to have an addiction or to think. Like, honestly, this sounds stupid and it sounds crazy, but if you're just smoking weed and your life is unmanageable, like, that's a problem. Your story isn't everyone else's story. Everyone has their own story. Pain tolerance is what their tolerance for emotional damage is. The normal person that thinks of addiction seemingly like the mainstream idea of addiction is either rock star drug addict or homeless drug addict in an alleyway, you know, with a needle. It runs so much deeper in your actions and your thought process, and that is where I struggle with it. And I mean, that's where every addict or alcoholic struggles with their addiction, is, you know, in the core of who they are and in the core of their mind. At least for me, it wasn't something I could do alone. It wasn't something that I was able to just think, oh, why don't you just moderate? Why don't you just stop? That doesn't make any sense to me. I have no idea why anybody would take one drink of alcohol. It doesn't taste good to me. I don't think it tastes good at all in general. I liked the effect produced by it. I like to get fucked up. That's why I like to do it. There's a lot of things internally that I struggle with this on. Like I've mentioned, when it comes to like the way I think, like in my addiction manifesting in other ways, coming at me sideways with whatever it be, work, skateboarding, women, like it can literally manifest in any shape or form for me. That's like what I struggle with today. I don't struggle with the physical substance problem anymore, but it's still a struggle in terms of like, it's like me against me. It's literally like the good wolf and the bad wolf. That is what goes on in my head on nearly an everyday basis. And some days it's not as gnarly as it is other days. And then other days it can literally fully take over And if I'm not constantly doing certain internal work on that, it can like always go back to abusing substances. That is where I will end up if I don't maintain some form of internal work on myself. Yeah, I don't know why this stuff is kind of hard to talk about. Maybe it's literally just hard to talk about because it's so personal and vulnerable and I'm afraid of what people will think. And not that I'm afraid of what people think about the fact that like I once did drugs and drank like that. I'm more so afraid about, and it doesn't matter what they think, obviously, but you know, I'm human, so my mind goes there just like everyone else. I'm more so worried about the fact that people think that they're like, oh, he's not even an addict. Why is he here? Why does he need this kind of help? Because he wasn't in an alleyway with a needle out of his arm. That's what I struggled with a lot in early sobriety and getting sober. I thought I wasn't like hardcore enough to be there. I thought I had to go out and like ruin my life more in order to get help. And that is not true at all. You don't have to dig like your bottom so deep to the point where you've lost everything and you're literally about to die or end up in jail in order to get help from something like that. That's the fortunate aspect of my story, is that I caught it early on. Like, I know that that's where I would have ended up. Maybe it would have taken years down the line, or maybe it would have taken a month, maybe it would have taken like weeks, who knows? Like, I don't know, but I don't really want to test it. I'm good with where my life is right now. I'm good with like not doing drugs and drinking and not having that crutch when I go out and socialize and do all of, I don't know, the things that like, that you're raised to accept as normal things that people do when they become an adult. Like, I've never had a legal drink in my life, and I've been perfectly fine socializing and mingling with people without having that sort of thing. I don't ever want to sound too preachy when I talk about this, and I always feel like I need to mention that because like, I don't have a problem with someone who does drink or who does do drugs recreationally. I wish I could do that, but I can't because I end up fucking crazy in an unmanageable wreck. Whether it showcases like in the outer world or not, like inside my mind and what I'm doing, I'm an emotional bankrupt of a wreck internally. The self-sabotage of everything is like really where my addiction like comes in. And I don't know, it's so weird to explain. It's so weird to try to explain to like someone who hasn't experienced it, to like help them try to understand where I'm coming from. And maybe, and like, I don't really care. It's not really my job to get someone to understand. I'm just making this because I know that someone out there could potentially use this to their advantage to maybe eventually get some kind of help. There's so many ways that I could trail off into this conversation to where like I could go into so much more detail about certain things. Really, I mean, it's unnecessary, and I think the big point is that you don't need to be like a piece of an entire piece of shit in order to like feel like you want to get your life together and abstain from, you know, doing drugs and alcohol if you think you have a problem. Like, I can't sit here and tell you you have a problem. You're the only person that can make that decision. Nobody can tell you this. Like, your parents can send you off to rehab and people can tell you like, hey, maybe you shouldn't do this so much, but you're really the only person that can ultimately make that decision. Feel free to comment all you want down below about this. I will be doing my best to try to respond to as many as I possibly can. These videos, when I do them, seem to get a lot of feedback because I know there's a lot of people out there that do struggle with this, that don't know how to get help and that don't know how to deal with it and don't know how to even admit or say that they have a problem. So if you want to privately message me on YouTube, I'll check there. It's harder when you DM on Instagram because I get so many that I don't see all of them. But yeah, I'm like open to a conversation about this sort of thing because it's like I'm helping other people. So, I mean, that's what this is all about. Obviously this video is going to be monetized because I got to pay rent. So, the question always gets raised too. Well, don't you think now that you've been sober for so long that you could probably handle yourself? Maybe that's true, but I don't really think it's worth it to even try because I risk losing all of this. I risk losing everything. I wouldn't be able to do this YouTube thing. I wouldn't have started it. I wouldn't have been able to like have the motivation to get my life together and to be able to try to pursue what I wanted to pursue and do what I want with my life if I was still actively drinking and doing drugs and abusing substances. How do I explain it? You can't think your way out of a way of thinking. It doesn't work. You have to act your way out of a way of thinking, if that makes any sense. It makes sense to me. If I act in ways that are contrary to the way that I am feeling, I generally tend to feel better or like talk to somebody about it. I'm not really the type of person that hides my feelings or that is afraid to talk about my feelings. When shit's going on with me, I talk to somebody about it because it's just gonna bottle up and manifest in other ways to where, okay, so being an addict and an alcoholic, it's easy to spot bullshit and you're a bullshit. bullshitter. You learn how to bullshit. You learn how to lie. You learn how to cheat. You learn how to steal. You know how to do those things because that's what you got to do to keep your addictive habit going in order to hide it from people or whatever, because it's not, it's, you know, it's a very selfish thing. So if I'm someone who's really good at bullshitting, like I can spot it pretty easily. If I'm aware that I'm bullshitting, it's hard for me to, like, you know, be okay with that. I don't know what my point of that even was. I don't even know if I got to a point or if that even made any sense at all. Yeah, there's no such thing as moderation for somebody like me. There's no really crossing back over that line that I did once cross over. I've survived this long without being like a social drinker. It's just completely unnecessary at this point. And, you know, I think a lot of the times I try to keep my opinions out of this kind of stuff because it's different for everybody and my experience isn't necessarily somebody else's experience. But I mean, for me, you know, drinking and abusing substances was kind of a way to pass the time and to try to feel good about my current state of life because I wasn't happy with what I was doing. And, you know, when I saw an opportunity to, you know, do this and to do what I want and to pursue, like, passions for a living as a career, I grabbed onto that, like, super hard. And I wouldn't have been able to see that opportunity if my judgment was clouded by drinking and abusing substances. I wouldn't have been able to do this. And that's what it does to me. It clouds my brain to where that's all I want to do because that feels good. So I'm just like, okay, I just want to keep feeling good. It doesn't matter what happens. I'm just like, okay, we need to feel good. But now, like, I have this solution here, which is, like, you know, what I do to maintain that. And I can't really... So if you haven't noticed, like, I haven't ever really talked about, like, what exactly the solution is. And, like, frankly, I can't publicly like this because I don't want to be a direct representation of that. Because say 2 weeks from now, I decide to take a drink and I fucking end up destroying my entire life. Then I become a representation of this thing that I do to help me stay sober. And people will look at that and be like, oh, that didn't work for him. So why would it work for me? That's the reason why you don't really publicly talk about it like this. That's why I never fully say in detail what it is exactly that I do. I mean, if you talk to me on a personal level, like, I can go into detail on it, but it's not something that I want to, like, attach to myself personally, because that kind of stuff happens all the time. It's called relapsing. People relapse all the time. It's a part of the nature of addiction and alcoholism. So that's why it's important to not, like, attach a person to it, because, you know, it's something that works if you put the work in for it. If I decided to go out and drink and get fucked up, that would mean that I'm not putting the work in, because if I was putting the work in, I wouldn't have done that. But yeah, to answer that question in a nutshell, there is no moderation and there really is no going back on it. I just have to accept it, which I'm perfectly happy and fine with being a sober person. To me, it just drinking and abusing substances, it's such a waste of time for me. This might not necessarily be, like, a good thing, but at least it keeps me sober and that's all that really matters. But this is, like, how I see my advantage. I see that since I don't do that, and not a lot of people, and, you know, there's plenty of people that don't drink and that don't do drugs. So, like, it's not that big of a deal, but for me, it helps me, and I see it as I have an advantage because I don't drink and I don't party and I don't do drugs and I don't concern myself with that. So that's my leg up. And if I was doing that, I wouldn't have that necessary leg up. Like, when things are really rough and when I'm not putting in the work on myself, like, that idea has sometimes kept me sober. And that's not the best way, but having that mindset about it definitely helps me. I hope you guys enjoyed this video here. I hope it was helpful for some of you. Really quick before we go, I do want to let you guys know, Slammin', the link is in the description if you would like to purchase anything from my brand. We are working on a few things that are gonna be pretty big this summer. I know you guys will be excited. Oh, just for old time's sake. And then just hurt me till I get my satisfaction. Go, you tell me to smile. You stick around and make it what you want.